Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This is the seventh video in the ESP32 series using the Espressif IDE, and today we will continue with the SPI peripheral. In the previous video we saw how to connect the W25Q Flash device with the ESP32, and how to read the ID of the device. Today we will continue with the W25Q Flash memory, and we will see how to write the data into the memory, and then read the data back from it. Please note that this video does not focus on W25Q Flash memory, we will cover the simplest possible way to write and read data from it. Rather, we are focusing on the SPI peripheral of the ESP32, therefore more attention will be on it. I have already explained how the W25Q32 flash memory is connected to the ESP32. Here I have the project we created in the previous video. We will continue editing the main file from this project, so let's copy it. Now create a new Espressif project. I am naming it SPI3. Replace the main file of this project with the one we copied from the previous project. Let's build it once. Alright, there are no errors, so we can proceed with it. I explained the use of address bits and address data in the previous tutorial. Basically, this parameter is used to prevent the ESP32 from reading the data while the address transmission is going on. The external transaction structure has command bits, which works in the similar way as the address bits. Basically, when the command is being sent on the MOSI line, the ESP32 will not read any data on the MISO line. It has the same use as the address parameter, but this is a separate parameter, so to differentiate the command and address data. Say for example, if the SPI slave device does have the 64 bits addresses, then we definitely need the command parameter as well. But in case of W25Q, the device has only 24 bits memory address, so use of command parameter is not a necessity. But anyway, using it looks better, as we will be able to separately define the command and address data, rather than combining them in a single variable. To use the command parameter, we need to declare the variable command flag in the regular transaction structure. I have defined both, as I am going to use both. Now let's define a 16-bit command variable, and another variable to track how many command bytes we want to send. We will pass the command data to the command parameter in the regular transaction structure. And in the external transaction structure, we will pass the command size to the command bits. The size is also in bits, so multiply the command length by 8. The rest of the function will remain the same. 9F hex is actually a command, so let me rename it to command. We need to change the SPI receive function accordingly. Command is the command we defined above, it is 1 byte in size, there is no address, so the size will be 0. We will store the received data in the RX data array, and we want to read 3 bytes from the slave device. Then we will combine the data received and make a 24-bit ID data from it. Alright, let's build and flash the project to the board. Let's see the output on the serial terminal. You can see the 24-bit device ID is printing every 2 seconds. So the command parameter of the transaction works fine, and we can use it in our code. Here is the datasheet of the W25Q32 flash memory. Let's check some basic details about how the memory is arranged inside this device. As mentioned here, for the 32 megabits variant, there are 16,384 pages, whereas for the 16 megabits variant, there are 8,192 pages. Each page occupies 256 bytes of memory. We can program a maximum of 256 bytes at once, so basically a maximum of 1 page at a time. To erase the data, we can erase a sector at the minimum, which is made up of 16 pages. You can also erase a 32 kilobyte block, a 64 kilobyte block, or the entire chip at once. It depends on how much data you want to erase, but erasing memory smaller than a sector is not possible. As I mentioned earlier, we will see the simplest possible way to write and read data from this memory. Therefore, we will not dig deep into every command, but rather focus on the ones we need for now. We are going to need the write enable command, page program command, sector erase command, and finally the read data command. Let's see the write enable command first. Write enable command must be issued prior to every page program, any type of erase, and write status register. To send the write enable instruction, we simply need to send the command 06 hex. Let's write a new function to enable the write. Inside this function, we will first store the command in the command variable. Then we will call the SPI transmit function to send this command over the SPI bus. Let's wait for 5 milliseconds, just to make sure the command is sent. That is all for the write enable instruction. Let's go back to the datasheet. We will read the data at the end. Here is the sector erase instruction. To erase a sector, we first need to send the command 20 hex, followed by the 24-bit address of the sector that we want to erase. Alright, let's write a new function to erase a sector. The parameter of this function will be the sector number that we want to erase. Remember that there are 16 pages in a sector, so the page number 0 to 15 are included in sector 0, then 16 to 31 in sector 1, 32 to 47 inches sector 3, and so on. Inside this function, we will first define the command, that is 20 hex. We also need to define the memory address, which depends on the parameter of the function. Each sector contains 16 pages, and each page occupies 256 bytes of memory. Therefore, the sector address is calculated by multiplying the sector number with them. We will again use the function SPI transmit to transmit this instruction. Although here we have the command and address as separate parameters, it doesn't matter in case of transmission. As long as we are not receiving data, we can transmit in any way we want. We now need to send 4 data bytes, 1 for the command, and 3 for the 24-bit address. So let's define an array to store 4 data bytes. The first element of this array will be the command. Then the next 3 elements will be the address data. As shown in the instruction diagram, the most significant byte of the address is sent first. So we will shift the address to the right by 16 places, to extract the bits 16 to 23 from it. Next, we will shift the address by 8 places, to extract the bits 8 to 15 from it. And finally, we will extract the bits 0 to 7 from it. We now have the 24-bit address split into 3 bytes, with the most significant byte stored first. Before sending this instruction, we must call the write-enable function. Finally, call the function SPI transmit to send these 4 bytes data over the SPI. Erasing the sector takes some time, so let's give a delay of 1 second, just to be on the safe side. That is all we need to erase a sector. The next instruction we will see is the page program. In order to program a page, we need to send the instruction 02 hex, followed by the 24-bit address, followed by the data to be written. Let's write another function to program a page. The parameters of this function will be the pointer to the data array, which we want to write, and the number of bytes to be written. We will use the same steps that we used while erasing the sector. We also need the page number in the parameter here. The memory address will depend on this page number. Each page occupies 256 bytes, therefore the page number will be multiplied with this value. The command to program the page is 02 hex. The steps to store the command and address remain the same. In addition to the command and address, we also need to send the data. So we will store the data in the array, but starting from the fourth element. The elements 0 to 3 are already occupied by command and address data. After the data is stored, the write enable is called to enable the write operation. Then the function SPI transmit is used to send the data array. The number of bytes are already present in the parameter, but we need to add 4 more bytes for command and address data. Let's give a delay to 200 milliseconds to make sure that the data was written successfully. Finally, we will see the read instruction. To read the data, the master needs to send the command 03 hex, followed by the 24-bit address. The master sends the dummy data for every byte it wants to read, but it is handled automatically by the ESP32. During the transmission of the instruction and address, the data out line remains high, and the master should not read the line while the command and address transmission is going on. Let's write a new function to read the data from the slave device. The parameters of this function will be the page number from where we want to start reading, pointer to the buffer where the data will be stored into, and the number of bytes we want to read. We need to transmit the command and address, so let's copy them from here. The command is 03 hex here. The SPI receive function already has all the parameters that we need, like command, address, buffer to store, and bytes to read. So let's call the SPI receive function directly here. The command is already defined, it is 1 byte long, the address is defined too, it is 3 bytes in size, buffer to store and number of bytes are already present in the parameter. Let's build the project once to check for errors. Alright, everything seems fine, let's proceed forward. Let's delete this part from the while loop. Here I am defining a string, which I will store inside the flash memory. In the main function, after initializing the SPI, call the function writeData to store the data into the memory. We will store the data inside page 0, the data is already defined, and the number of bytes are 11. We need to typecast the data pointer here. Alright, after the data has been written to the memory, we will read the data back. Again, we will read page 0, the data will be stored in the RX data array, and we will read 11 bytes. Now print this data as a string on the terminal. Alright, let's build and flash the project to the board. We will see the output on the terminal. We did not receive any data from the slave. Well, I forgot to erase the sector before writing the data. Alright, let's build and flash the project again. You can see the received data on the terminal. It is the same string which we stored in the flash memory. Let's see all the transactions on the scope once. I will start from the beginning. The first data is sent by the master, and that is 06 hex. We call the function to erase the sector, which in turn calls the write enable function. This is when the master sends the command 06 hex to the slave. Then the master sends 20 hex, basically the sector erase command, followed by the 3 bytes of address data. Again, the master sends 06 hex to enable the write operation. This is when we call the write data function. The master enables the write by sending this command. Then the master sends 02 hex, basically the write page command, followed by the 3 bytes of the address, followed by 11 data bytes. You can see the data bytes sent by the master are the same as what we defined. Then the master sends 03 hex, the read data command, followed by the 3 bytes of address. On receiving the read instruction, the slave starts transmitting the data from the address mentioned by the master. To read each byte of data from the slave, the master needs to transmit some dummy data at it. So everything works just as we programmed it to work. Let's change the string to see if we get the new output. Instead of reading 11 bytes, this time I will read 15. Alright, build and flash the project to the board. Here you can see the received data on the terminal. We have received the same string which we stored, but along with it there are four weird characters. This is because we read 15 bytes, so the remaining 4 bytes are all FF hex. We will see this on the scope again. I will only focus on the received data part here. You can see here the last 4 bytes are all FF hex. Well, before writing the data we erased the entire sector. When the flash memory is erased, the existing data is replaced with all ones, basically the FF hex. We only wrote 11 bytes to the flash memory starting from the beginning of it. Therefore the rest of the data remained the same FF hex. This is what we get when we continue reading after 11 bytes. I will do a dedicated series on W25Q flash memory devices in the future. These videos were focused on the SPI transactions, rather than the flash memory. This is it for the video. I hope everything was explained properly. I will make a mini-series covering ADC in ESP32 in the near future. That's it for today. You can download the project from the link in the description. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.